What's up, everyone? Welcome back for the next race. All right, so yeah, trying out Special Stage Route 7 for the first time. Also trying out this car for the first time. This is apparently a 14-mile long track, so I'm not gonna waste any time. Let's get this fucking show on the road. All right, so let's see what this track is all about. Again, this is my first time ever racing Special Stage Route 7. I've raced, obviously, Special Stage Route 5 a lot in Gran Turismo 3. And a little bit in Gran Turismo 4 as well. But Special Stage Route 7, I've never even heard of. Seems like it's going to be a fun track, though. Whoa, holy shit. Again, I have no idea what I'm doing here. It's my first time ever on this track, so. Alright, cool. Going pretty fucking fast here. It's awesome. Whoa, shit. Ah, that's pretty cool. This little tunnel here. Okay, again, I have no idea where the hell I'm supposed to be going, because I've never raced this track before, so hopefully I'm on the right track. Yeah, this is a pretty interesting track. Alright, so we have ourselves another tunnel here. Yeah. Oh, shit. This track is pretty impressive. It's got an interesting kind of design to it. It's a lot of fast areas. Some interesting scenery as well. Certainly is a unique track, that's for sure. Whoa, what the fuck? Are those fireworks? What the hell? That's fucking awesome. Dude, what? Oh my god, that is badass. They got fucking fireworks on this track. Damn, that is sick. Wow, that is cool. I like that. Alright. Yeah, I kind of fucked up during that little part of the track there, but that's alright. Alright. Yeah, I gotta say, I'm definitely liking this. Got those badass fireworks over there? That is fucking awesome. God, that is gorgeous looking. I love it. I love every second of it. That is awesome. Awesome. Man, that is fucking cool. Alright, well, I like this track 1,000% more now. This is badass. I love it. Got a lot of room to really open up your car on this track, you know? Just floor it and don't look back. This is definitely proving to be a very fun track. A lot of fast areas. Some fireworks in the background. That is spectacular. I love it. Fucking awesome. Yeah, some really cool shit. Definitely. I am loving this. I mean, look at this. I'm going 100 fucking 80 miles an hour. That's pretty badass. Ah. Yeah, couldn't quite make it there, but that's alright. Yeah, just some really cool shit on this track. Again, I don't know this track very well, so please excuse me as I may do some stupid shit like hit the walls. But I gotta say, really like what I'm seeing out of this track. Definitely an interesting track layout. Seemed to be doing okay, though. This car's definitely got a decent amount of speed, no doubt. Especially on the long run. This car is fast. Oh, whoa, shit, got real loose there. Kept it going, though, so that's good. Yeah, I gotta say, really like what I'm seeing out of this track. Some really fucking kick-ass shit. Again, just a lot of wide open area. You can just go all balls out with your car. Some really good stuff. And then those fucking fireworks. That is just brilliant. That is a really nice touch. That is fucking awesome. I love it. Yeah, God, that is awesome. I just love the shit out of that. Yeah, those fireworks in the background, really nice touch. I don't know who's in charge of, you know, making this track, but, or the visual effects, but really, really great stuff here. Polyphony did a fantastic job with this track. The layout is very interesting. You know, a lot of wide open areas. There's some sharp turns, but a lot of wide open areas, you can just unload your car and just let it run. Definitely my kind of track. I've always loved the, you know, nighttime tracks just in general. Like in any racing game, really, but especially in Gran Turismo. Yeah, I kind of messed that up both times, but eh, happens. Yeah, then I was working around getting around that guy. Which I did manage to do. Yeah, it's really fun to just, you know, floor it and then go all out and see what your car can do. Got a lot of opportunities to do that on this track. But yeah, I gotta say, that car overall handled very nicely. Can't really complain about it. Yeah, and again, this was my first time racing this track, so obviously I made a few stupid mistakes, but, you know, it is what it is. And then you got the fireworks going in the background, always cool. Yeah, you get a pretty good view there. Yeah, almost spun out there, but I was able to keep it from spinning out, which was good. And then that sharp-ass turn. Which I was able to get through. I mean, I didn't do it that well, but still got through it. Yeah, I get another view of those fireworks there. Again, just some really awesome stuff. You know, it's those little attentions to details that really set the Gran Turismo games apart from other, you know, racing games and shit. Because you can really feel, like, the care, the love, and the passion that the Gran Turismo team at Polyphony, you know, that they put into their games. You really get a sense of that. At least, I don't know, I get a sense of that anyway. That they really put a lot of passion, hard work, and dedication into their projects, and it shows. We'll be right back. But yeah, really just some good stuff on this track. Again, just opening the car up, flooring it. I love it. Going as fast as it'll let me go. But yeah, that was a great race, a lot of fun, no doubt. Yeah, this was a hell of a long track, though. I mean, it's 14 miles, so definitely not a short track, that's for sure. They got a little loose there, obviously. Yeah, you get a great view of the fireworks there. Again, just some really kick-ass stuff. Yeah, all around, what a great race. Excellent racetrack. Very, very different, but very fun. Definitely a very fun racetrack. I enjoyed that one. Well, guys, that will do it for that one, so stay tuned for the next race, and until then, peace out.